Everyone, Jess Nerdspot here. Check out what I got to do with decals that I ordered from BD15 props and decals. Decals again from BD15 props and decals on the OG 93 Megazord. It looks pretty freaking sweet now.
Well, I did the OG Megazord use the legacy their label for it. Let's go ahead and see what magic we can do.
I guess so. With the Legacy Megazord, I honestly didn't have to go ahead and do that much, considering that it already did come with some of the labels. So obviously, you know, some of the more prettier, shinier labels are these ones that did go ahead and come with it. So I added some of the minor labels here. You could probably see with these ones. When I ordered this Legacy Megazord, I originally was just going to have it for displaying it with the Ultra Zord, in which I have, you know, obviously Legacy Ultra Zord, or Legacy Titanus, and the Legacy Dragon Zord. But yeah, I mean, this one, he didn't come with some of the labels, so I did go through and add some of them, you know, obviously with the Saber-Tooth Tiger, and then if you look at the Triceratops, he does have his as well. Overall, great stuff here. So I still have a lot of the labels for the Legacy on backup, so that's pretty cool. But yeah, BD15 decals and props, guys. Links in the description below for more details. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that little shindig of me just working on those Zords. Obviously, Gugan was my best friend with using that for the OG Megazord. And those decals came out very nicely. Makes a lot more detail pop up within your Zords. I would highly recommend to go ahead and check them out, like I've been saying before. Links in the description below. Guys, it is kind of a weird time to be a Power Rangers fan, to be quite honest with you. We got stuff going on in Go-Go Power Rangers and obviously in the MMPR comics as well. There's a lot of rumors coming, you know, around. There's a lot of rumors a few weeks ago circulating around the fact that, you know, Ryu Soldier could be the next Power Rangers adaption. We'll talk about that a little bit. And then, of course, today there's been an announcement from Power Rangers Twitter page that basically announced that we were getting a Rita and Lord Zedd 2-pack. WTF to that. Obviously, we're anticipating Power Rangers Beast Morphers Season 2 premiering in about 2 weeks or so, which brings up a lot of different questions and everything like that. So, let's get down to it. Oh, and to start off with, I forgot to mention, Machine Sentai Kira Major is going to be coming out in March. Now, a lot of people from the trailer either said, you know, hey, I don't like how the Zord's arm looks or anything like that. Honestly, guys, you can probably check out a clip of the trailer playing here. And I'm pretty pleased by what I'm seeing so far. I think some of the villains look actually really cool. The fact that they're giving each and every one of the characters there jobs or things that, you know, normal people do, that's something I really like to see. And that, I mean, the green, not the Green Ranger, but the yellow Kiramajor, or Kirame Yellow, he's an esports player, number one esports player. The Kirame Pink, she is a doctor. And I think Kirame Green is, you know, a track star. And then obviously, and the Kirame Blue is an actor, which seems pretty interesting, guys. I really can't wait. A lot of people are kind of upset because it's another trope to where they think, you know, oh God, the red is another obnoxious tool bag for a leader. Well, I mean, look how Lucky from Q Ranger ended up. People loved Q Ranger, so I'm gonna definitely go ahead and keep up with it. I'm definitely gonna go ahead and watch that. I'm very excited to see Kira Major. You know, on the next one here, guys, people also wanted to bring up, you know, Super Sentai, and you know, it's been a tradition to where Super Sentai seasons have been adapted, thus bringing over, you know, either good seasons of Power Rangers we love or the bad seasons that we probably hate. Now, another thing too is that the latest rumor mill a few weeks ago, they announced that Ryu Soldier, Kishiryu Sentai Ryu Soldier, would be made into the next Power Rangers adaptation. A lot of speculation behind that, and a lot of people saying, you know, what's the deal? What's the use of that happening at this time? Why is Hasbro doing this? We've already had Dino seasons a few years ago. And, you know, to that point, yeah, you're completely right when it comes to that. So if you think about it, not even less than almost 2.5 years ago, we had Super Dino Charge. And to bring up another, you know, Dino trope, it probably would be a little too early for them to do that. Although, you know, dinosaurs are really, really popular and loved among a lot of people, that doesn't really translate over well to stuff like Power Rangers or anything like that. Honestly, I don't think it's going to be Ryu Soldier. It is a rumor just for now. So, like I said before, I mean, I think I've even said this before and talked with a couple of people, we could be hearing about the new season anywhere from here, as of right now, onto, you know, the announcement at Power Morphicon, where, you know, usually they'll reveal the cast at Power Morphicon, so hopefully anytime between that, we'll get to hear about that soon. Gosh, guys, I'm really excited. Beast Morphers, let's go talk about Beast Morphers, guys. Beast Morphers has been an excellent season so far. Now, a lot of people thought it started very slow and didn't really engage people or fans as much as some of the prior seasons would have. Well, what caught my eye was a relationship between Devin and his dad. Devin being a phenomenal Red Ranger, in my opinion, probably one of my favorites. Definitely a huge upgrade from some of the previous seasons that we got within the Neo Saban era. You know, honestly, when you think back at it, him compared to, you know, people like Jaden, people like Troy, people like Tyler and Brody. I mean, Jaden was pretty good Red Ranger.
Troy, he's no Captain Marvelous. I'm just going to say that. And then the likes of, you know, Tyler. Tyler was an awesome Red Ranger. He was very energetic, very passionate of a character. I absolutely loved his character in Dino Charge and Super Dino Charge, Dino Supercharge. My fiance is asleep on the couch, and she even loved Dino Charge as well. I would ask her about it, but she's completely out. Another thing too, guys, is that when taking that into consideration of that, it had a lot of different callbacks and Easter eggs within the series. The writing itself felt like it was hearkening back to, you know, times of Power Rangers Time Force, you know, the relationship between Wes and his father. And we can even think back to, you know, the multiverse and kind of where exactly everything is going to go after so long, or where this takes place in the actual timeline or the actual multiverse of the Ranger universe. There's a lot of theories behind that too. Now, overall, I mean, the development for all the characters, not only with, you know, Ravi and his struggles with wanting to be an artist and hiding it from his mom, and wanting to save Roxy, because that is, you know, his love. That's his, you know, girl. He wants to be saving her. I mean, the character development between Zoe, the B-Spots were amazing. Roxy and Blaze, absolutely great characters. Liana Ramirez, bless you for being an awesome villain in this show. You were so great. Colby James, great job being an excellent villain here as well. I definitely want to see more of Evox and more of that suit. I want to see more of that suit used in the second season, guys. Definitely a lot to look forward to. And overall, I would have to say my favorite Ranger of the season, that goes to my boy, Nate. My boy Nate, the Gold Ranger, definitely one of the coolest transitions that he had from, you know, being the lowly scientist to being, you know, his own person, coming out strong. And of course, you know, Steel. Steel is just a big dumb. He's just himself, man. Overall, Beast Morphers was an excellent season. Can't wait to see what season 2 has in store, especially with how we left off on, you know, season 1 with Devin's dad possibly being infected by radiation from not the morphing grid, but the cyber dimension. A lot of speculation behind that. And I think I was supposed to mention something about the Lightning Collection. Yeah, let's talk about the Lightning Collection, guys. It was announced last night, a little bit late last night, that there was going to be a new GameStop exclusive to celebrate the 25-year anniversary of Rita Repulsa and Lord Zedd's marriage by releasing an exclusive GameStop exclusive 2-pack of Rita Repulsa and Lord Zedd. Now, there's a lot of mixed reactions behind this. People saying, you know, well, Lord Zedd was in Wave 1. We already had so much of an issue trying to find him. You know, and I was one of those people. I was super patient about it. Is that going to stop me from probably getting this 2-pack? Babe, what do you think?
No.
She knows me too well, guys. Don't tell her that I'll be pre-ordering it when I get paid next, all right? Anyways, too, I mean, the exciting part is that we're finally getting an excellent Rita Repulsa figure itself. The only complaint that I have about it is that we're having to wait till August for this thing to come out. And I'm actually getting to meet, I'm actually going to try and meet Carla Perez, who played Rita Repulsa in one of the later series of Power Rangers as well. Basically, the 2-pack is excellent, and it's got, you know, obviously the cool effects and everything here. Obviously, you get Zedd's staff, the growing ball itself. Rita's staff is in there. There's a bunch of little trinkets, you know, the crystal that comes with it, the effects pieces that, you know, obviously look excellent. Hasbro knows what they're doing when it comes to these figures, in my opinion. Think back to, you know, how much popularity some of these figures got. The Captain America from Avengers Endgame, the Worthy Cap that came out he's super hard to find. You know, I'm probably gonna shamelessly drop about $45 to get that figure, but shh, don't tell the missus, please. She's awake anyway, so I'm gonna she's awake anyways and kind of is giving me a dirty look when I say that, but yeah. Another thing too, I mean, Hasbro is also doing great quality with these figures, not only with the Power Rangers line and the, you know, obviously Star Wars line is another big one too. Recently with, you know, obviously having figures come out in, you know, with Darth Raven figure being an excellent one to have. Gosh, guys, the Mandalorian's figure, the Mandalorian, they released a figure, a Black Series figure for him, and it's already flying off the shelf. I know I already paid for mine from Amazon, and it's not even going to be shipping out to me until September. So that tells you something, guys. That it's huge. Hasbro knows what they're doing when it comes to these types of figures, and I know that some people are going to have some, you know, different opinions on that. Whether, you know, hey, the qualities of these figures are crap, they're just in it for, you know, a cash grab. They're a corporation and a business, guys. We're the consumer. Either buy the product or just, you know, walk away from it and not buy it at all. It's completely up to your choice. But as far as, you know, the paint issues and minor issues like that, it doesn't take but, you know, under 5 minutes to fix some of these issues here on the service. I mean, take a look at, you know, what happened with Dino Charge Gold, for example. Part of the neck was supposed to be white like it was on the show, and, you know, we all saw that it wasn't. So it's as easy as, you know, getting a paint Sharpie, which is, you know, white or something like that. So, I mean, something as simple as this can definitely go ahead and fix a lot of the issues that your figure may have. A lot of paint issues, things like that, they're on the surface of it. But overall, guys, what do you think about everything that's going to be happening here? Are you happy about the Rita and Zed 2-pack? Are you excited to see Power Rangers Beast Morph for Season 2? I mean, who are you hoping to see adapted in the next Super Sentai? Or who do you see, or gosh, guys, what Super Sentai series are you excited about seeing adapted in the coming future, guys? This has been Jess with Nerdspot Collective. I want to thank you all for hanging out here, and it's been a busy few weeks. I'm going to be back with great videos. You guys have an awesome rest of your week. Peace.